In this video, I'm going to show you how to replace a colored roundlet in a H2 searchlight signal mechanism. Why is the reason why I'm doing this video? It's because recently when I was browsing on eBay, randomly looking for railroad signal parts, I found these pieces here, which these are searchlight signal roundlets. Basically, these are the little lenses that go inside of the searchlight signal. I honestly did not know that you could find these separately, but it was just a random find that I found on eBay. But what caught my attention was this one. This one is a lunar white roundlet lens. Lunar white in searchlight signals, they're quite common in certain areas along rail yards or entry to rail yards, but I always wanted a US&S searchlight signal with a lunar white, but those are really difficult to find. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to install this one right here, and maybe in a future video, I'll show you how to install a yellow one in a searchlight signal GRS mechanism that I have that only has two reds and a lunar, which is what I have in my collection, but that will be in another video, hopefully in the future. But we're mainly going to be focusing on the lunar white mechanism swap in the H2 mechanism. So we'll get started on replacing the lunar white roundlet with the green lens in this H2 mechanism. The tools that you're going to need is a half inch wrench or a 13 mil, which is what fits a half inch as well, and a flathead screwdriver. So the first thing that we're going to do is take the parabolic lens and bulb out the back, lay it down, and to give it a little extra room, this is where the wrench comes in, where you, if you want to, but this is what I like to do, is to have less stuff in the way. You remove the bolts that hold the power source to where the bulb is connected to. And careful not to push these in because they somehow go inside of the H2 mechanism, and I do not want to have to fish them out, so obviously be careful when you take these bolts out. And the plate that goes to one of the bulbs comes out right here, and to prevent accidentally push the bolt that the plate was sitting on, you just thread the nut back on, so then it won't disappear inside the mechanism, so you don't have to fish it out. And get the other one off. Do the same thing with this one, so you won't lose it. And parabolic lens bulb is out, and we'll put that to the side. Now the next step, which is fairly easy on the H2 mechanisms, is that this glass window right here where the parabolic lens sits and the bulb, there's just these three flathead screws that are holding it all in. And all you do is just take these three screws, sometimes these screws would get stuck because of corrosion from being in service for so many years, so you gotta be very careful so you won't snap the heads off of these or strip the screws, or even worse, you mess up the top where you insert your screwdriver. And after, when they come out, this whole piece just pops right out, and then you have access to where the roundlets are inside the mechanism, or the brains of the internal mechanism, which is further down there. And some weird term or name that some guy who used to work at Union Switches and Signal once told me that when they're working on stuff like this, they call it brain surgery. So if any of you have ever seen an internal mechanism like this, this is what one looks like without the light and the parts that are in here that hold it in here look like. And theoretically, this is what the disc looks, the disc mech inside of it looks like when it goes in, when the screens are placed in front of the light to produce the colors. And when there's no electricity, the internal mechanism's counterweights bring the red lens to its central position, which is a safety feature, and it was very revolutionary for these internal mechanisms and for searchlight signals back in those days. It's just sad that little by little that searchlight signals are disappearing from service, but now let's continue on replacing the green lens roundlet with the lunar white. Inside the mechanism, just the roundlet lenses are just being held by this one tab, and they just set on these little tabs right here. So theoretically, it's just something that's just plainly simple. So I don't know if I can get this on camera, but what you're going to do is that you're going to have to carefully lift this up right here. It is soft brass, so you got to be very careful when you're lifting this up. You don't want to snap it or bend it, otherwise you're going to be in a lot of trouble. So you just pull up the tab just slightly, and then you just slowly and carefully lift the roundlet out of its spot, and it just pops right out. It's very simple. So now the green lens is out. Now we'll replace the lunar white where the green was. So it's theoretically the opposite way to do it. So you have to carefully put the roundlet in the little tabs on there and carefully pull this up. Be careful not to snap it. There you go. It's as simple as it gets. That's how you change a roundlet in a US&S searchlight signal. Now we will replace everything back, and then we'll throw this end unit inside of my H2 searchlight signal housing, and we'll see how it looks like with the lunar white. Alright, I swapped the other H2 mech that was currently in this one with the one that I swapped the lunar white in it. Let's see how it looks. That is really cool. And that's how you swap a roundlet colored lens in a US&S H2 searchlight signal. I am very pleased and I'm happy with the results that this came out with, because it's something about lunar white aspects in searchlight signals that's very satisfying to me. I've only seen one, which was at Western Avenue in Chicago at the Metro station with a Metro train going into the Western Avenue yard. But I have not seen a US&S or any searchlight signal with the lunar white aspect out in service on the railroad. You don't see them that often, but I thought it was pretty cool that I got to do it with this one. Unfortunately, that this mechanism does not belong to me. It belongs to a good friend of mine who has a US&S or H2 Searchlight signal setup that he's planning on doing later this year, or hopefully sometime in the near future, and he wanted a lunar white aspect. And as luck would strike, I found the lunar white aspect along with the other lenses on eBay for him, and I told him that I would swap it into the mechanism if it was possible, and because it was easy enough to do so, I thought I'd make this video. And if you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and also subscribe if you really want to see more content on my channel. It inspires me to make more videos like this, and I'm happy to see if any of you like watching my videos. It still keeps me inspired to make more videos like this, so be sure to look out for more future videos. Take care, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.